विश्वास एंड फेस एंड अदर इश्यूज आई थिंक मोहपात्रा सर विल एनलाइटन अस आई एम हैप्पी टू वेलकम ऑल द सीनियर ऑफिसर्स फ्रॉम द डिपार्टमेंट हू हैव जॉइंड अस एज आई कुड सी सेवरल ऑफ देम आर ऑलरेडी देयर प्रिंसिपल चीफ कमिश्नर्स कमिश्नर्स डिप्टी कमिश्नर्स दे हैव ऑल जॉइंट कमिश्नर्स आल्सो जॉइंड टुडे आई थिंक इट इज द continuation in second meeting Mahapatra sir is dealing short while ago he was addressing with our chamber our institute of chartered accountants of india friends before I hand over to Ramakant ji sir I would like to remind you that on 25th january monday we are having very important meeting सर फ्रॉम 4:30 PM डिटेल्स विल बी शेयर टू यू लेटर वेलकम एड्रेस आई हैंड ओवर टू रमाकांत जी इनानी सर प्रेसिडेंट FTCCI टू प्रेजेंट हिज वेलकम एड्रेस ओवर टू रमाकांत जी इनानी रमाकांत जी प्लीज
थैंक यू रामदेव जी सॉरी इन बिटवीन आई लॉस्ट द कनेक्शन ऑन होप आई एम ऑडिबल
यस सर
On behalf of FTCCI and Telangana and AP Tax Bar Association, I extend a warm welcome to Sri J.B. Mohapatra ji, IRS, Principal CCIT, AP and Telangana, and other senior officers of the department, representatives of Telangana and AP Tax Bar Association, distinguished participants. I thank the department and its senior officials for interacting with members of trade and industry. On the issue of Vivad Se Vishwas scheme to settle the long pending tax disputes. As per the sources, the department has been able to settle almost 35,000 cases of direct taxes within the ambit of this scheme, aimed to resolve the tax dispute among various parties across the country. We thank the department. At FTCCI premises and other areas, apart from wide publicity through mobile vans and through media, also to facilitate guide in the respect of direct tax Vivad Se Vishwas scheme. As a chamber, we have disseminated the contact numbers and mail IDs of designated authorities for to our members. As the due date is fast approaching, the principal CCIT. Is kind enough to interact with the stakeholders to clear further doubts and apprehensions under the scheme. This scheme is a good opportunity for the assessees, appellants to settle their disputes related to penalties and interest, and to avoid the uncertainty of outcome of the pending litigation. Thank you, Ramdev ji.
Thank you, Ramakant ji, sir. No one wants dispute. That is the main motto. Not even department, not even taxpayers. We too hope that our taxpayers who are still planning are having some sort of confusions. All those things will be clarified now, and they will come forward to settle their disputes if they desire for peace and for. Doing their business and concentrating more on their activities. So, with this hope and expectation, I request and invite Sri J.B. Mohapatra sir to kindly share your thoughts with us. Mohapatra sir will be for a short duration with us as he is scheduled with another committee meeting. I request Mohapatra sir to please join in and share your thoughts.
Yeah, thank you, Ramdev ji, and the forum for having invited me. This one probably in very quick succession to the earlier one, probably that was in some 3 weeks earlier. But we want to get the contact with the Tax Bar Association and the Trade Association going until the duration of the scheme. that is up to 31st of Jan 2021. You know, some numbers I wanted to give to you on an all India level and also at the level of AP and TS for you to make an assessment all by yourself as to where we are standing as a state or as two states vis-a-vis the country as a whole. Now, as on 4th of January 2021, all India, we had 97,000 applications, form number one and form number two. At that point in time, AP and Telangana were having only 3,000 applications, right? On this day, I do not have any knowledge as to the number of applications all India is having. But AP and Telangana is having our application load of 3,643 applications, form one and form two, as on date, which I believe is a number which can be improved by a distance. If we, both of you, and sorry, both of us, we can put our heads together and make some fresh, the last round of efforts to making VSB a success. Now, the numbers, the gross numbers, where from I am collecting this 3,643 is coming from, is that we have calculated a total number of around 21,324 cases as cases ripe for VSB scheme because of many indications in those demands. They are litigated demands at various places, at CIT appeal level, at the level of the tribunal and High Court and Supreme Court, and they fulfill otherwise all the conditions which make them entitled to get under the scheme. So we are determining the gross VSB potential cases as 21,234, out of which as on date, sorry, as on 15th of January, that is last Friday, we were able to convert 3,643 cases under the VSB. That roughly makes it around 15% to 16%, right? The All India target, for your information, and between you and me, is 30%. So we are looking at around 7,100 or 7,200 cases coming from AP and Telangana alone. We are at 3,600. So another 3,400 cases, potential cases, have all that is going for them to get under the scheme. So these are the basic numbers which I am giving you. For your information also, let me tell you that AP and Telangana as on today is doing far better than the Pan India numbers as far as collection is concerned. As on today, Pan India, that is all states, all principal chief region, all across India, is showing a deficit of 9% in their collection, net collections, right? Which was a deficit of 36% at the end of the first quarter of the advance tax in June 2020, right? It has come down to 9% as on today. AP and Telangana also has a miserable first and second quarter. We were down minus 36% at the end of the June quarter, down minus 22% at the end of second quarter. And at the end of the third quarter, we are at minus 6.8% AP in Telangana, right? But as on date, whereas all India, it is minus 9%, AP in Telangana is just 3%. It's just minus 3%, right? So AP in Telangana as a tax jurisdiction is doing three times better than what all India is doing as far as growth rate is concerned, although it is negative. But with your efforts, AP in Telangana has comfortably been beating throughout the year the closest competitor, which is Pune, and it is just about 2,000 crores away from Chennai. So if it gets over Chennai also, it will be one of the greatest, what you call, upheavals in the tax history, which I would not like Chennai to stagger in its tax collections for us to increase. I also want that to increase. Chennai to increase and AP and Telangana to increase. But I'll just give you, I'm giving you a rough overview of AP and Telangana's position in the All India tax map. We, AP and Telangana, which was throughout behind Pune last year, has beaten or has been beating Pune all throughout the year. And as on date also, we are plus 4,000 crores nearly away from Pune. And as far as Chennai is concerned, we normally year on year, for date and date, we are always down by 11,000, 12,000, 15,000 crores, lesser than Chennai. But now we are just about 2,000 crores from Chennai. So it is a touching distance from Chennai also. So I am putting these numbers before you to see that AP and Telangana as a tax jurisdiction has got a lot of potential going, and it is one of the tax jurisdiction which the powers that be at Delhi, they look up to, look forward to, and they look this region as a region which comprising the best brains in information technology, in ITES, in pharma, in health, in mining, in coal, etc., etc. So this is a region which has attracted the attention of, which has always been attracting the attention of people and the policymakers. So at this point in time, as far as BSB is concerned, we are a little lesser position as compared to others. Other tax jurisdictions are at 25% to 30% of the cases, whereas we are logging in at around 15% to 16%. I think with your effort, and with our support to your efforts, we can achieve, we can target the 7,100 numbers, which will be 30% of all the potential cases to go under BSB fairly easily. But for that, from our side, as I told you earlier also, in the last meeting, I told you that we have two local coordination committee who are equipped to handle all your queries which cannot be satisfied by the designated authority. And beyond that, there is the principal chief's office, my office, and there on a reference, we can talk to the CBDT also and get very quick responses to your tax queries. But my point again, it is not about marketing a scheme, but it is about telling things which you already know, that this is a scheme which has got all the potential of being the best and the most timely of all the schemes. It gives you powers to stop litigation on payment of taxes alone. It also allows you, it gives you that leverage, that handle to also terminate the departmental proceedings on payment of 50% of the tax only, right? It gives you immense powers and also frees you from the burden of interest and penalty and possible prosecution later on. As I told earlier time also, litigation has a real cost to you. It has a real cost also to the department. It takes away our time, our energies, our resources. It takes away your time, your energies, and your resources also. But beyond that, I will always tell you that litigation also depreciates the value of your assets, right? An asset which is created out of taxpayer funds, if there is a litigation attached to any asset, then the value normally depreciates. So the point is, erosion in value of the assets, it also can be very tangibly addressed by you under the provisions of the scheme. There are technical issues and there are logistical issues. As far as technical issues are concerned with regard to administration of the scheme, the tax authorities, that is the designated authority commissioners, principal commissioners, there are 12 or 13 of them all across AP and Telangana, they will address those issues, right? Form 3, if you feel that the Form 3 has not quantified the demand correctly, you can always go back to the designated authority asking for a revised Form number 3. Form number 3 can be revised as many times as there are mistakes which are pointed out by you, or even so motor by the department can do that. So kindly do not feel hesitant at any point in time to correspond, to interact directly with the designated authorities. If designated authorities is not able to satisfy the queries with regard to admission of your case to the scheme or any interpretational issues on which you do not agree with him, that is the administrative forum called the local coordination committee, which you can always tap into for an answer. Otherwise, you can come to the principal chief directly to me. And if I do not satisfy your case going under the scheme, then I can always make a reference to the board for a response. We have laid out a forum for technical addressing of the issues about the logistical issues with regard to not attending to the rectification applications, not giving appeal effect to past orders or duplication of demand, etc., or the CPC demand, etc., which is not being addressed to by the designated authority, which is preventing you from going under the scheme. Kindly bring all those issues to the attention of initially of the designated authority and thereafter to me. We can take care of these technical issues with regard to your actions which should have been done in your case and not addressed, which can be addressed right now. There is a clear and present pressure on the department to look at all the pending grievances which are connected directly to the VSB, right? So kindly take advantage of the current situation where the department also wants the number of VSB applications to increase. So this is the right time where you can correlate the VSB applications or the potential VSB applications to your pending actions which have not been carried out so far, and we can very well make out, we can help you to make out a clear case of VSB by also aligning your demand as per your records. So these are my initial issues. There would be technical questions. There could be technical questions on this one. At this forum, I refrain from answering to technical questions with regard to the scheme and the interpretation, which are available in two circulars of the board in April and December 2020, which can be referred to. If there are issues beyond those 89 answers which have been given by the board, which can be handled at my level, kindly put it in writing and give it to me or send a mail so that I can answer quickly. We will go the distance with you in order to make sure that a potential case under VSB does not get away for the benefits under the scheme just because there are some actions pending at the level of the department. I stop at that, and I'll be glad to hear from you.
Thank you, Mohapatra, sir. I would like to share a few things about Viva Se Vishwas. In few of the applications where earlier Form 3 was sent to the that demand means the assessment order was incorporated instead of only disputed tax. So we have requested the concerned authority within no time we got it.
Yes.
Form 5 is also received in major cases. Final certificate. So I'd like to share with all the members who have joined that is really good service department is rendering in settling the disputes, not only through this scheme, through effective implementation of the scheme. So I request all the members to take advantage of this scheme. Here you have to pay disputed. Yeah, as soon as you get Form 5, because that Form 5 is the final settlement certificate that your dispute is settled up to CIT level. You have to file only let the commissioner appeal that you have opted for this scheme and you are not interested in continuing with the appeal. Because there is no such withdrawal procedure prescribed. So I request all the members to take advantage of this. With this brief, I request any query is there. Mahapatra sir will be available for few more minutes with us. Kindly seek your explanations. Any difficulty which you have faced in getting your issues resolved, you kindly share with Mahapatra sir and his technical team will answer to that. Over to Ritesh for this question and answers or queries and session.
Members can unmute themselves and ask the question.
Yes. Ritesh, if anybody has put any question or query,
there is no query in the chat box.
Yeah, yeah. Any query? So I want to just a little bit of confirmation from Mahapatra sir. Sir, what my experience I have shared now, is it fine, na?
No, that Ramdev ji.
Yes, sir.
As I told. That at any given point in time,
yes.
The department's records with regard to your demand,
yes.
may not correspond to the demand as reflected in your books.
Mm-hmm.
This situation happens all the time.
Yes.
That is why at the time form number 3 is issued.
Yes.
I would always want all the taxpayers and the tax councils to look at the form number 3 very closely and find out whether demand that is reflected in form number 3 corresponds to the actual demand as per your books. If there is any difference, bring it to the notice of the designated authority, right? And he will gladly, and under the law, he will amend his form number 3 and issue you a fresh form number 3. So point I am saying is that these 5 forms, form number 1 to form number 5, if you go through them closely, if you look at form number 1, form number 2 is only an undertaking. Form number 1, you have the search cases and the non-search cases, and in the search cases and in the non-search cases, you have the CIT appeal plus assessee. Then you have CIT appeal, then you have the tribunal assessee, then tribunal department, high court assessee, high court department. And also for TDS issues, with regard to search issues, with regard to 264 issues, and with regard to arbitration and conciliation also. So it is in 4 parts, A, B, C, D section, right? All these demands which are there, disputed demand, disputed tax, as per form number 1, right? As per form number 1, they should normally have a 1-to-1 connection to form number 3. But form number 3 is not as driven by your form number 1, but as per the records of the department. Sometimes the records of the department may not correspond to the present situation, because of some pending actions. So that is the reason as to why form number 3 must be checked very thoroughly in order to look just the one thing, whether the demand reflected therein, it corresponds to the actual or it is not. And the moment you bring it to the notice, you have to bring to the notice 2 things. One is there any action pending on behalf of the department? Is there any rectification application which is pending? Is there any appeal effect which is pending? Is there any other thing which is pending which has got ramifications for VSB? As you know, VSB does not take into account a lot many things. It does not take into account waiver applications pending or pending matters with the AAR or pending matters with the ITSC, Settlement Commission, this, that, and the other. It does not take into account wealth tax. It does not take into account interest tax. It does not take into account securities transaction tax, commodity transaction tax. It takes into account only income tax and only in given situations. Okay? And the given situations are that your demand is this much. If your demand, as reflected by the department, suffers from infirmity, it is all the more reason as to why you come back to the department and say, sir, this is not right. Actually, this demand has been paid, or this demand needs to be rectified because of the situation. So the point I am making is that always look at the demand in form number 3 and try to find out whether that is the actual demand or the demand needs correction at our end. Thank you, Ramdev ji.
Thank you, sir. That is what I was sharing actually, that it was not that difficult.
Yes.
I got demands rectified in form 3. Yeah. After giving all the details, it was easy. So as soon as I filed my 4, within a very short time, I got also form 5.
That is the reason why I am telling you that this is an exercise. This VSB is an exercise which will give benefit not just in the VSB, but also in allowing you to get many other things settled at the level of the department.
Yes.
Pending actions with regard to that assessment year for which you are going under VSB. Yes. When you go under VSB, the demand has to be crystallized. It has to be made concrete. That's the reason as to why VSB is allowing you also to set right the books of the department, at least the demand part, in synchrony with your books of accounts. So that will also help you and the department in aligning both the demand position.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. That's true, sir. I request our senior members, SV Kabra sir is also there. So if we have anything to seek any clarifications or any redressal, please go ahead. Please unmute yourself. Kabraji, unmute yourself.
Thank you, Ramdevji. Thank you, Chief Guest. Thank you, all the members. The scheme is very clear. There is no doubt. Last time I read the point, now it has been very clear to me. There is no doubt for me now, the scheme. Over to Ramdevji.
Thank you. Thank you, Kabraji. I think our past president Amrit Kota is not visible. I think he was having some issues, and yeah, later on I think he has got it clarified. Amrit.
Okay. Okay.
Amrit is not visible as he is busy in. But he has clarified and he has opted for a scheme in several cases also, sir.
Okay. Ramdevji, my short address to you, summing up all that has been told by you and me and all the people here, is that we are looking at doubling the numbers in 15 days time. There are 2 weeks to go before the scheme. Finally, like in the last time I told, it cannot be extended beyond 31st of December 2020, right? I gave a confirmatory no. But the right thinking people, sympathetic people at higher levels, they probably heard you much better than they heard me. And it was confirmed that this is extended to 31st of January. Now, 31st of January, we have 2 weeks to go, right? Beginning 18th. So we have the 18th week and we have the 25th week, right?
Yes, sir.
So in these 10 days, 10 working days, 12 full days, including Saturday, bank working and all those things. So we'll have to double the numbers. Today's number is 3,643. At 16% of the total potential cases, we and you also would like this number to go up to 30%, right? So yes, there is a challenge before us and before you. But if we both can come together and look at those kinds of cases which have got all the potential of going under the scheme. For example, as I told, 234E, 234F cases, right? The tedious cases, right? 201, 1A interest cases and all those cases, which will add to the numbers. At this point in time, more than the tax effect, this, that and the other, look at those critical cases to add the numbers and where you think you are missing out by not going under the scheme. Now, there would be cases which are complicated to come under the scheme. And even though you try, probably they will not be entitled, right? Like people coming for condonation after 6 years that you condone and we go under the scheme, those are patently IFSC not acceptable, neither to you nor to us, right? But
yes,
where cases are there and the potentiality of that case is there, technically they're satisfied, and the taxpayer has got all the reasons and all the compulsion to go under the scheme, but if we do not help him to come under the scheme, it will be doing injustice both to the scheme and to the taxpayer. So find out those, find out with your convincing power and your persuasive powers, right? I am connect to the taxpayer mostly through you, and you are the eyes and ears of the department at the field. So I want you, with all our support at the level of logistical level and at the technical level also, we'll support all out for your efforts. Try to convince as many people to go under the scheme so that, you know, we have the numbers to show for our efforts. Thank you.
Sure, sir. We will put message to all the members. I request our Chamber of Commerce also to spread a message. We'll prepare a message listing out the benefits and other advantages through small cases which are there, as you suggested, for 234 interest penalties, 220 cases also. So we'll certainly spread the message, and we'll pursue also, if possible, to all the persons who are having such cases to please offer it. Still, time is there. Don't miss it out.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Certainly, sir. Certainly, I thank now for formal thanks. I invite our Vice President, Sri Nagesh Garu, K. Nagesh, to present his vote of thanks. Mr. K. Nagesh.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Good evening, sir. Good evening, friends, sir. Thank you, respected Principal CCIT, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, Sri J.B. Mahapatraji, for sparing very good time and explanation, very good this thing, sir. For today's interactive meeting for Vyavasaya Vishwas Scheme, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir. We'll do our best, sir. Our president will do the best for our betterment of the scheme, sir. Thank you all the senior officials of Income Tax Department. Thank you all the members of AP Telangana Tax Association and the Federation of Telangana Chambers of Commerce Industry for attending our today's interactive meeting. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.